And first, I'd like to thank the member for Lakeland for her passion and for her passion for women and girls around the world who are put at risk by groups like ISIL, and for her great speech here in the House today. I am going to be sharing my time with the member for Central Okanagan, Similkameen Nicola. And Mr. Speaker, it was an honour to be able to participate in this debate in last March when our government at the time brought forward a motion for debate and a vote in the House of Commons. That's a hallmark of our Conservative government. That's something that we started in this place. Previous Liberal governments, whether they were deploying troops to Afghanistan or redeploying them to Kandahar under the governments of Jean Chrétien and Paul Martin, did not consult the House. And I was going to congratulate them on adopting that Conservative practice, but of course we've now since learned that before the Prime Minister had even finished moving the motion, that they had already made the decision without consulting this House. So, you know, I guess we thank them for the consultation after the fact, after they'd already made up their minds. But at least we are having a debate here in the House, which is, again, a new phenomenon for the Liberal Party. So we congratulate them on that. I did want to talk a bit about previous Liberals and their views in previous governments. I want to quote from the former Deputy Prime Minister, who said, "Canada has a good reputation in the world, but let's make no mistake about it. Canada does not have a history as a pacifist or a neutralist country. Canada has soldiers who are buried all over Europe because we fought in defense of liberty." And that is a quote from John Manley. And it was a quote that he made after 9/11, when there was some concern about what the Canadian response would be, and there was some that were putting forward the response that Canada was a peacekeeping nation, that in fact we didn't fight, that we didn't get our hands dirty. And I heard that disturbing trend again today in debate from Liberal members. A Liberal member from Surrey Newton, when I was here earlier in the debate, said, this Liberal motion is a return to Canada's type of international engagement. Mr. Speaker, that is an insult to all of the brave men and women from across the generations who have fought in World War I, the fight that shaped our nation, World War II, responding to the Holocaust and to the threat that Nazi Germany posed to the world, to Korea, and in Afghanistan. There's again this whitewashing of our combat mission in Afghanistan, where it is said, well, we just trained in Afghanistan. At the end of that engagement, yes, Mr. Speaker, the focus was on training. But prior to that, there was a counterinsurgency that our men and women in uniform were involved in, 158 of them paying the ultimate sacrifice with their lives to serve this country for the greater good and for vulnerable people who were under the thumb of the Taliban. And those brave men and women went to make life better, as the member for Lakeland said, for young girls who couldn't go to school, for those that were killed simply for not worshipping in the same way as the Taliban and their twisted ideology. So let's not forget that the Canadian way has been to fight injustice, to protect the innocent, and that we've done that throughout our history, and we shouldn't simply talk about the blue helmets and the blue berets. That is a proud part of our military history as well, but let's not diminish the work that our men and women in uniform have done across the generations of this country, who've built this country. They fought for what was right, and that's what, and certainly when we brought this motion forward in the last Parliament, I remember respecting so much former Member of Parliament Erwin Cotler, who refused to stand with the Liberal position because he believed, like our government, in the responsibility to protect. And he saw that by doing what we were asked, and I can't believe in the member for Lakeland gave in her speech, a Liberal member saying that our men and women are hundreds of support staff, our trainers on the ground, and our six CF-18s were tokens, that this was somehow just a token effort that wasn't really worthy of support. And if we've really meant it, I guess we would have sent in the PPCLI or some light brigade. Mr. Speaker, that's what we were asked to do. We were asked to send CF-18s, and that's what we did. And for that member to minimize that as tokenism is a disservice to the men and women in uniform who have been serving this country valiantly for the last 18 months, and she should be ashamed of herself. Mr. Speaker, perhaps there's a reason why that sort of rhetoric comes from that side. And it's because it starts at the top, with the Prime Minister, when he was leader of the Third Party, when he was asked about our mission with six CF-18s participating with the coalition. What did he say? And I know they don't like to hear it, but I'm going to say it again. He said, "We're just going to whip out our CF-18s to show everyone how big they are." That's what the contribution of the Royal Canadian Air Force was. What an insult to the people of the Royal Canadian Air Force. Then again, in the debate, when it was brought to the floor, and perhaps he had to tidy up his language a little bit, he said, "The only thing we're contributing is a few aging warplanes." Again, Mr. Speaker, an insult to the men and women who fly those planes. And let's talk about what they've done in their time acting on behalf of the people of Canada. What has our Royal Canadian Air Force done? They've flown 1,378 sorties, 783 support aircraft flights, 251 airstrikes, and 399 ISIS targets destroyed. And that's what we're here to debate. That's what we on this side of the House and the official opposition are here to say. Why do we support the continued bombing by the CF-18s? Because it's working. Because prior to the bombing campaign by the coalition, ISIS was rolling across the open country through Syria and Iraq with impunity. They were taking whatever they wanted. They were rolling like a standing army. And what has happened because of the air campaign? They have seen their supply lines cut off. They've seen their financing reduced. They have seen their occupied territory reduced by 25%. It is working. The CF-18s are part of that. And again, I heard the government members today saying, well, there's lots of bombers in the area. We're only providing 2.5% of the sorties. Well, Mr. Speaker, then why is it such a big deal to keep them there as part of the multi-pronged approach? We have said clearly, the Prime Minister, the now member for Calgary Heritage, said when he brought forward the motion in the last Parliament, he said, we must do both humanitarian and military. We must respond with humanitarian support. We must respond militarily. And again, what we see now is this Liberal government saying, well, we can go with training, we can bring in more refugee support, all of which we support, all of which we supported when we were in government. But the other thing that we supported was the continued use of our CF-18s and the brave men and women who've done such a great job delivering for the government of Canada and for the people of Canada in this fight against ISIS. And what I find ironic or interesting in this motion is that there are some who are trying to portray this as a philosophical opposition to bombing. It's tough to be philosophically opposed to bombing when Canadians will still be painting targets, when Canadians will still be providing refueling, when Canadians will still be providing reconnaissance for selecting targets. So why wouldn't we allow the men and women of the Royal Canadian Air Force to continue to deliver those bombs on behalf of Canadians? Why wouldn't they continue to degrade and destroy ISIS? Because we're supporting the bombing effort, we're just not supporting our men and women in the Royal Canadian Air Force to continue to do the job that they do so well. So, Mr. Speaker, ISIS is a terrorist organization that deserves to be destroyed and degraded. Our brave men and women in the Royal Canadian Air Force have been doing a fantastic job in delivering for Canadians and for the Government of Canada. They should stay there, and that's why I support the amendment and will be opposing this motion.